loud. Big
shaped clue.
Big body versus big sword. Starting off on stadium as is normal. JFID versus KFID. I'm digging it.
Oh, he is KFID. That's great. All right. Starting on stadium. I mean, it's just the classic Smash Bros. At this point. I don't know if either character particularly prefers this stage. I'm sure Cloud's fine here.
Oh, yeah. Cloud in this stage is, I don't think it's one of his like most advantageous stages because he can't really like trap people's landings, but it's King Dedede. Anybody can trap this character's landings.
Absolutely.
Basically, you have one chance to get down with neutral air, and if you lose that chance, you're about to get opened up. We're seeing a lot of these like attempts actually by Kimchi to jump in, and against Cloud, that's kind of difficult.
Very dangerous. You know, thinking about it with the stage thing, I feel like JFID probably should have elected to ban. I mean, I feel like more of the stages benefit Cloud more than they benefit DDD.
The stage, yeah, I can definitely see that. I think he might have been either like just coming here for a comfort pick because like, everybody in MDBA loves the stage.
Right. Absolutely.
Back air to force DDD off stage here. A couple of these Gordos, they really haven't been playing too much of a role. As such a big disjoint Cloud has, you can just kind of smack him away for free. You don't have to commit to a damn thing. You can just toss out a back air.
Smart by Kimchi to not abuse Gordos too much then, yeah.
There it is. That's the JFID classic. He just goes ahead, empty short hops, back airs once, and then just, you're going to drop shield, so I am going to limit cross slash. Stock one going his way.
Kimchi's going to struggle to find a way in to get this kill.
Kimchi's actually trying to do the same thing. Like,
yeah.
Kimchi just full hop back airing, like, please drop shield. I want this. I need this.
JFID, not the most blatantly aggressive player. I think it's unlikely he's just going to run into a back air. But Kimchi found one there for sure.
And that runoff forward air will take that stock. Great presence of mind to recognize that Cloud's got a little bit of an awkward spot just above that ledge. Toss out a hitbox. The character can't do a damn thing about it.
Gotta be willing to edge guard Cloud.
Look at this uppy out of shield too by JFID. That move is silly. What is it, frame 6 or 7?
I actually have no idea.
All right, now back here battle as both characters just kind of like face off and see who doesn't have to go in. Living on Cloud, though, so are we going to see JFID try to save it? No, going for the Blade Beam, hope for Shield Poke. Not working out so well for him. Full hop back air, forward air safe on shield, and then immediately Kimchi responds with the same thing, full hop back air.
Swinging straight back.
Just, I want to hit your shield for free, and you can't stop me.
Oop.
Up tilt, force him high. What is the edge guard? Just barely missing that back air.
Really looked like it connected to me.
Shaving a haircut right there. Okay, ooh. Neutral air? Not only hitting the penguin, but sending the Gordo back to sender, too.
Air's not dead.
No. PGA taking
right.
It off the top.
Golf club swing. Oh, all right. Nah, I'm already getting called.
All right, thanks for joining me for this short amount of time, though, Kara. Hopefully, we can get some more commentary later on. All right, so as it stands here, we're kind of seeing Kimchi struggle to get this last stock. The first one was taken off by forcing JFID to edge, but he hasn't really shown the ability to pressure JFID and take away stage control. All right, there we go. But that back air will take it as JFID a little bit too aggressive with that jump in. Good B reverse there on the neutral beta. Pull JFID out of shield. Kimchi doing a very good job here, racking up some damage. This match is just about even. Either player really wants to commit, but it looks like JFID's throwing out a few more unsafe options here. Kimchi punishing appropriately, forcing out that air dodge. Can't make anything out of it, though. I'd like to see more forward airs from JFID, as that seems to outrange even King Dedede's back air. Here, how does this man get down? Looks like just a fastball neutral air for a burst option. You know JFID was fiending for that side B, but now limit is gone. So are we going to see him try to play a little bit more defensive here? Doesn't look like it. Close range Gordo toss. Great getup attack, though, recognizing that Kimchi was trying to land aggressively. And now JFID, that's the thing. The second that he runs forward, he loses out on his limit charge because Kimchi is responding appropriately with these very well-spaced aerials. And now it looks like JFID's back into its corner. No limit and no gauge, really, either. You're just going to have to take this with a raw back air or a smash attack, it looks like. All right, neutral air, get a little bit more charge. Platform drop back air, exactly. Do that again. Again, the wall has been placed here, but JFID's doing these like unsafe full hops. This is terrifying, and there we go. I don't know if it was a shield poke or a shield drop, but great recognition by Kimchi to see that he could get that up tilt to poke at Cloud's feet and take game one. Come on, So I think the key to that win there by Kimchi was just recognizing that J-Fid loves jumpings. And Cloud's jumpings are kind of free sometimes, so you can go ahead and punish those. We're actually seeing the switch off of Cloud and onto Palutena saying, if you ain't gonna let me jump in with my Cloud, how about I toss out the goddess to see what she can do? You can play a little bit more passively here with auto reticle, but I mean, really, you could have done that with Cloud charging limit as well. So I don't think that this is going to really necessitate a change in tempo or pace here on JFid's behalf. He's just going to go ahead and have to use those safe aerials. And we got our third commentator of the set, my man Parappa's back.
Third commentator? All right. Yeah, Kimchi, he knows what he's doing with DDD. He knows what he's doing.
Yep, took game one and a close one here and necessitated the force by JFid off of Cloud.
Yeah, the J-Fid is switching off his main is a rare sight. He's been using Cloud for as long as I can. I've even known the dude.
Exactly. His Palu isn't bad. It's a solid secondary. I just don't think it's as clean, I'd say. He does the same thing with Palu, though. I mean, yeah, back air pretty nice, too.
Same game plan. It's just, you know, Cloud just doesn't do it quite as efficiently in terms of just how the character works.
True.
But J-Fid, I'm not sure how his Palutena is exactly because, you know, this is my first time seeing it, so. Well, so far, it looks like it's doing okay. It's holding its own, but it's still at a deficit against Kimchi, who's going to be living for a long time. Wow, nice parry against Akashka. Man, not going to be able to get that one.
Yeah, that's always going to be the problem here, is that if you let Kimchi jump above you and then allow him to turn his back to you, you're going to catch one of those. Like, they're basically safe on shield. Even Palutena, who has great burst options and great aerials, doesn't really have the range to challenge it.
Yeah, her hitboxes are generally, they're good at stuffing stuff out, but if it's a hitbox that's that huge coming from above her, then she's not really able to contest it that well. The Nair, yeah, it's DDD, dog. The character's going to live.
I don't like that back off right there. It seems like JFid got stuck on stage and then like buffered a roll, perhaps?
Yeah, that was a free out smash in my eyes, but yeah, JFid not showing he does have a little bit less expertise in this character than his Cloud.
I'm digging that, though. Test the shield with the back air and then immediately say, if you hit a button, you're going to get caught up with this.
Yeah,
great
for
sure. Cross-up.
But again, JFid's still at a deficit, and against DDD, yeah, this is a character that if he has a lead, then he can really make things annoying just on the fact that approaching him is, it's kind of a chore. Just on the fact that you have to worry about Gordo, and if he grabs you, you can just take 25 or something. It's weird. It's a whole lot of weird stuff that DDD just does in general.
Yeah, I never understand this character. Every time I get beat by it, it's like, okay, but why?
Yeah. That was an unfortunate SD. He thought he was going to land on stage, but yeah, he did not quite work out the way he wanted to, so.
You're kind of seeing why he wants to do this, though. It seems like the Palutena is much better when you can force Kimchi into disadvantage, but you just haven't seen a lot of that this game.
Yeah. I mean, in general, if Palutena gets one hit on DDD, then he's probably going to take 40. And on top of that, he's going to have a really hard time landing against those aggressive aerials that Palutena has, which come out faster than Cloud's.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, JFid also is not really spacing his explosive flames the way he wants to. Like I see him kind of doing accidental tap-in long-range explosive flames instead of close-range explosive flames. Might want to tighten that up if he's going to play Palutena as a pocket or secondary.
In addition, it seems like he wants to be more patient with Palu. He's established multiple times that he doesn't have to approach by tossing out his explosive flames and auto reticle, and then he goes in. Like, we've seen two or three times now where he runs into like a dash grab, and that's just not going to work out against a character like DDD that can just retreat and toss out safe aerials to pressure you.
Yeah.
So yeah, if you want to play Palu, you've got to be a little bit too patient.
Yeah, you got to know how to just really play defensive. In order to make the most out of your character, your opponent trying to get in on you. I like what Kimchi's doing. What he's doing is he knows how his character works. If you try to jump out of hit stun when you're getting launched into the blast zone, it actually improves your chances of dying because DDD pumps himself up and gets fatter, which means he touches the blast zone easier. So that's the reason why he's able to live so long. But that explosive lane to catch the Gordo. Wow.
That was great. The Gordo just stood there. Kimchi had to basically look at him and be like, okay, yeah, I guess that's it for me. Stock down. So only 75%, not at all something that is like beyond the realm of possibility here, but JFid's got to get down first.
Man, did you see that? Did you see that catch? Yeah. He read the air. He waited for the air dodge. He covered the platform with a back air in case he fell down to it, and then, oh, your air dodge? Okay, well, he's in there.
Kimchi's doing a lot of little things right.
Yeah.
And I think that the fact that this is a secondary is definitely like showing itself here. JFid's okay, and JFid held up.
No, at that point, I don't even think you can DI that properly.